getting quite used to having you around.
After a weekend of nature calling, the stench in there knocked the clerk on his back when he opened the door, and we managed to escape. Neither Pete nor Phil was really cut out for running, though. They got picked up at the end of town and hanged the next day, which seemed harsh to me.
Thank you. You should try it.
This batch is perfect. We can ship it whenever you like.
There. All right, so, not sure if you heard, but the revenuers are out blocking roads now, stopping wagons, making everyone very nervous. But we ain't gonna run. We ain't gonna sit here and just wait for them to find us. And you go and remind them how nothing's certain but death and taxes. Minus the second part.
Thank you.
Okay, then. We need to win back some favor with the saloons round here. Just the way it works. We help them out, they help us out when the revenuers come round asking questions. Anyway, there's a bar near here that's having a few problems. Not sure what exactly, but I said I'd send someone over to sort it out for them. And I know what a good Samaritan you are.
Thank you. Morning.
About to go belly up.
Can't believe my own.
Best not be interrupting me now. Move on with you. Thank you.
Good to see you again.
Fine. I ever told you about my fishing? I could bore you into an early grave with my angling tales. That's the thing about fishing, or hunting, or anything else. Do it as much as you like. Just don't talk about it. It's boring. Now, the reason I tell you about my fishing is the creek down there has been taken over. Murphy's brood destroying the reed beds, turning everything to silt, spoiling the habitat. So get their boats, won't you? Down the Camasa.
Ashamed to shoot a feller in the back. I'm alive, ain't I?
Don't I know?
Go!
island.
Done with that last little job. I've half a mind to say let's open a bottle and all that loose.
Oh, if it ain't my favorite little helper. Hey, you timed this well. We were just talking about a little waste disposal problem we're up against.
We were.
See, we do a lot of trapping.
Yes.
And try to use as much as we can, of course.
Well, just look at my belly.
But the trimmings still pile up. We've tried burning them out back, but they just don't catch that well.
Oh, and the smell? Hoo-hoo-wee! Strips the hair clean out of your nose, it does.
So, if you could source us some oil, a whole lot of oil, we reckon that might help things along. There's wagon loads of the stuff at Cornwall Kerosene and Tar. And I'm sure a rich feller like Mr. Cornwall won't miss one or two. We'll pay you for it, of course.
Ha ha ha.
like...
Superstitious type, are you? You are making quite a name for yourself. Little Bird told me about some lucrative opportunities. Might involve Capitale, too. I know. This whole Capitale business is just a little too civilized, ain't it? Don't sit right. Risky business these days, getting from one place to another. And certain kinds of people got more to lose than others. I ain't talking no legitimate businessmen either. I'm talking common crooks on the lam. Running from old John Law on account of the dollars they stole. And running from Signor Martelli on account of the Capitale. Now I leave the law to handle their own affairs. As for the rest, that's where you catch up to them. Good hunting.